Hello! Do you want to know how to make this cable? Then let's do it!
Step 1. Make sure you have the right tools for the job. You will need the following. Step 2. Put the boot on. Very important. Step 3. Cut enough of the cable until you get a good grip of the string. Once you do, cut through the outer jacket. I like to work with 4 centimeters, give or take, as I find it easier to untwist. Be careful so you don't nick the cables. Cut the excess of the jacket and the excess of all wires. Step 4. Spread the wires away from the plastic cross. Step 5. Cut the cross with the cutting pliers and be careful not to nick the wires. Cut the 4 wings. Step 6. Separate the wires while straightening them, then follow the pattern to make it easier. So, we're going to start with the green first. Now, some people like to use like a blade or something to really straighten it like this. I'm not a big fan just because I want to make sure that these cables are 100% intact, because I really don't want to nick anything, but hey, you do you. So start stripe green, then we're going to go, we're doing the T568A, by the way, guys. And again, you don't have to go too crazy, straighten it. It is harder if you're doing a Cat6A, for example, because it is harder to get in some of the connectors, but because it's a Cat6, then it's fine to get through. So there we go. Just hold everything together. Step 7. Align the wires with the connector. The end of the blue jacket needs to pass the hole on the housing, on the plastic housing, but not pass the line. So it needs to sit in between, then cut the excess on top. But be careful. If you cut too much, you'll have to restart. Very important. Let's get our connector here. And remember, we're facing down, so make sure. I've seen so many people get this wrong. Look where it's sitting. You just went past. You do not. Obviously, a little bit more would be better, to be honest. But this is passable. Okay, so you can still crimp it like this. See, you want to get right past this. So hopefully you can see it. So I might chop just a tiny little bit, guys. I'm feeling dangerous. I'm feeling spicy. Oh yeah, baby, that's what I'm talking about. So I got stripe green, stripe orange, I got blue, then I got stripe blue, then I got orange, then I got stripe brown, and then I got brown. Step 8. Double check the wires entered correctly in the right order, which we just did, and make sure all wires are touching the end of the copper. Very, 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 very important, guys. How do you check that? Well, you can get really close to see, but I'm gonna use my magnifying glass. Ooh, the green, the stripe green is not all the way in. There we go, so I'm gonna try it again. So this is very important, guys, honestly. A lot of people skip this. Oh yeah, there we go. So the stripe green is now definitely touching. I can see it. Beautiful, they're all touching. Step 9, crimp. And this will go all the way. Look at that. You cannot push it any further. And that's exactly how you want it. You want to go all the way in. And make sure you do once. One good crimp. One good push. So let's do this. Yeah, baby. That's what I'm talking about. Look at that. It's definitely been crimped. Step 10, slide, boot over, and test. If it's working correctly, you should see exactly like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful.